As a giant scale service provider, another thing that the service provider has to worry about is online evolution and growth of the service. Because services are evolving continuously. The Gmail that you're accessing for getting your email today may not be the same that you accessed a month back. So since the services are continuously evolving, the servers at the data centers have to be upgraded with the new version of the software, or maybe new nodes are being added, or maybe all the old nodes are being retired and brand new nodes are being brought in to serve the user community. Whether it is hardware or software upgrade that needs to be done, that has to be done with the understanding that while that upgrade is happening, there's going to be loss of service. Again, the DQ principle comes in handy in measuring what exactly is the loss that we are observing of the service when we do this kind of online evolution and growth. The first choice is what is called fast reboot. That is, bring down all the servers at once, upgrade them, and then turn them back on. So this diagram is showing you time on the x-axis and the loss, DQ loss on the y-axis. And what you're seeing here, this is the time for the upgrade per node. So the amount of time a node is going to be down in order to do that upgrade, whether it is a software upgrade or a hardware upgrade. And this y-axis segment is the DQ loss per node. So if I bring down a node and upgrade it, it's going to be down for some amount of time. And this is the amount of server capacity that is lost, the DQ that is lost as a result of one server being down. If all the servers are down, which is what is happening with fast reboot, then for this entire time, the area bounded by this green shaded rectangle, we're going to have no service. The ideal is here in terms of the total amount of DQ we want, and the axis is saying how much is the DQ that is lost. And what we are saying is, if we do this fast reboot, that fast reboot is going to bring all the servers down for a certain amount of time that it takes to upgrade them, and for the entire duration the service is unavailable. This idea of fast reboot is particularly useful in situations where we can use diurnal server property. For instance, if you think about services that are being all across the globe, we can use factors such as, oh, this is nighttime for the user community, and the users have probably gone night-night, and therefore they're not going to access the service. This is a good time to bring down the whole service and upgrade the service. So that might be a situation where fast reboot is very useful. So we are assuming that the user community is segmented so that they are directed to geographically different locations, and we can use the diurnal server property to do this off-peak fast reboot of chosen replicas of the services. In this figure, this segment that I'm showing you here is the DQ loss per node, and the total DQ loss is of course n times DQ, where n is the number of servers that are undergoing this fast reboot. So in other words, for u units of time, there is complete loss of DQ with fast reboot. An alternative to fast reboot is what is called a rolling upgrade. Now here, what we're doing is, rather than bring all the servers down at the same time, we are bringing one server down at a time and upgrading one server, bringing down the next server, upgrading it, and so on. This is what is called rolling upgrade or wave upgrade. And in this case, services available all throughout. There is no time that we are saying that the service is completely unavailable. But for the entire duration of time, the duration of time here is n times u, because u is the upgrade time per node. And the upgrade, because it is a wave upgrade, is going to last for n times u time units, where n is the number of servers being upgraded in this fashion. But during that entire time, service is available, but in every u units of time, there's a DQ loss of this much bounded by this area during the entire upgrade process.